Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest has co-starred in the Oscar-nominated film Selma and The Blind Side.
Now he's warming our hearts as the lovable, dependable Hollywood on the own must-see hit series Queen Sugar. Love it. Please welcome Omar J. Dorsey. Yay!
What's up?
Hello.
What's going on, sis?
Hello there, sir.
Good, good.
Come on down to the circle.
Let's make it happen.
Come on down to the circle.
Well, how goes it, sir?
It goes quite well. How you doing?
I mean, good. It's good to see you on this Monday.
You dig? Mm-hmm. I saw you on a Saturday.
Saw you on a Saturday down to the Southwest Cab picnic.
Sure enough, I just invaded y'all a little
thing. Yeah, you did.
I ain't even go to Southwest.
I know you did. So there we are, Selena. My high school has this huge alumni cookout. Here I am. They're like, Omar over there. I was like, hey, me and Selena interviewing him on Monday. Went over there and took a picture. You're from the Atlanta area.
I'm from Decatur, Georgia.
East
definitely.
Side. East side,
man.
Day.
Columbia Drive.
Come on, man.
Yes,
that's where I'm from.
I know where you're from.
Okay.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
All right, let's get into this interview. So listen, your mother really played a hand in the way that you are as an actor. Tell us about your upbringing and her love of theater.
Yeah, my mother is an amazing woman, Dr. Naomi Dorsey. She was a theater teacher at Henry County High School. She ran the drama department at Grand Forest Baptist Church.
Wow.
And so, man, I've just been in it since I was like 2 years old. I remember just going and watching her direct all these high school kids. And I was like, I want to do this one day when I grow up. And, you know, she just nurtured it.
Yeah.
I was doing a talent show. She had me doing the 23rd Psalms when I was like 4 or 5 years old. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
Right.
And it was just, you know, she trained me for it.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Well, I tell you, you play a character down to the Queen Sugar that is just a man that we all wish we had.
Gotcha. I know. Yeah.
What part of that character do you identify with yourself?
You know, Ava called me. I was doing a movie in the Bahamas, and she called me. She said, I want you to read the script. I wrote a character for you that I think that you're a lot like, and I want the world to see you the way I see you. So I read the script, and I was like, which character are you talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Hollywood. Mm-hmm. She said, that's what I see when I see you. And so she said, I need the world to see what a strong black man who loves his woman can, you know, looks like on screen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I said, I'm for it. You know, I feel like I try my best to be that way at home.
Mm-hmm.
I know it's not as attentive as Hollywood, but, you know, we all have a lot to learn. When you watch that show, I'm learning a lot how a woman should be treated.
Mm-hmm. But you weren't really surprised then of the outpouring of support that you saw from women because, you know, you talk about how being typecast is something that, basically every actor and actress doesn't
100%.
Want to be typecast. Right. So this is a different look for you.
Right.
So I guess, were you surprised at the outpouring of love that you got from women?
I was extremely surprised. Like you said, you typecast. The last TV show that I was on right before Queen Sugar was Ray Donovan.
Mm-hmm.
I played the baddest dude in the world. It was a fun role to play, but I was going through the airport, and people were like, oh, I hate you.
Right.
And I'm like, oh, yeah. You know, the character was a crazy homicidal maniac.
I mean,
I did my job, which is cool. So then, you know, to transition the very next year when I'm walking through the airport, oh, I love you so much. It takes away the typecast.
Yeah.
You know, now women see, they probably didn't watch Ray Donovan, but they watch Queen Sugar.
Yes.
So they're like, oh, that's Hollywood. I love you.
Yeah,
you just
had
none of it. But yeah.
Yeah, and it's crazy because even at the cookout this weekend, everybody's like, oh my God, it's Hollywood. Oh my God, it's Hollywood. And it's like women were flocking towards you. So from the relationship that you portray, what do you think is the most loving thing that a man should do when showing that type of affection to his wife?
You know what? One thing that that men don't do a lot of is listen. You know, and that's like, hey, look, I don't listen sometimes. I think when you listen, a woman might be talking for 20, 30 minutes, but at the end of that conversation is when this is what I really want to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
And if you sit and listen and not just like, I just want to solve this, let's solve it, let's get it on out, get it on out. You can't do that. You have to let a woman speak and, you know, express herself, because when you do that, then, you know, communication is just,
it's
the top priority.
It's so key.
Right,
yes.
Right.
Well, when we get back, we're going to talk about how key this communication is with you. We're going to return more with talented Omar J. Dorsey, so don't go anywhere.
Yes. We are back on Sister Circle Live with Queen Sugar's Omar J. Dorsey from Decatur, Georgia.
That's right. That's right.
Yes, and I got to keep hearing how they're down from the Decatur.
I know.
From down to the Decatur. Yes. Okay, so, Omar, you have worked with, well, Queen Sugar is critically acclaimed, and Ava DuVernay, the amazing Ava DuVernay, is the director. She also worked on, she's Selma, and you worked on that with her.
Right.
Working with someone of her level, mm-hmm. how has that been able to inspire you in the work with her, but then in the work that you do without her as well? Mm-hmm.
You know, she's just dynamic. Mm-hmm. Everything that she does, she's an Emmy winner, mm-hmm. Oscar nominated. She should have won the Oscar for Best Director. Selma should have won Best Picture, but I digress.
It's fine.
Just to see the way that she works, it's made me say, okay, I'm being lazy right now. Mm-hmm. So now I'm working with her a little bit on this Central Park 5 that she's doing it for in New York right now. Mm-hmm. And the hustle is just ridiculous.
Wow.
You know? And what she's done for female directors will be seen through perpetuity because we only have female directors on our show. I've never been directed by a female other than Ava DuVernay, mm-hmm. you know, in my whole life, and now I've been directed by 40 female directors.
Man,
wow.
That is beautiful.
Yes.
Absolutely. Let's talk about your co-star and your lady.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Now, the first time you all met, Tina Lifford, she said you were just in your phone the whole time, and, you know, What happened?
Tina Lifford has an active personality.
Mm-hmm.
With a camera, she has an active personality. No, what it is when I first met her, it was for a screen test.
Mm-hmm.
And she was sitting there. I don't like to talk to actors. I don't like to be talked to before an audition.
Okay.
So I was letting her have her moment, have her time. And I guess I wasn't a little bit, hey, girl, how you doing? How's everything going? I need you to be focused.
Mm-hmm.
Because when the cameras come on, then, you know, we can just shoot right up.
Right.
And we can have, you can be exactly where you need to be.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But she thinks that I was being funky. Now, look, you gotta understand, it was a Saturday morning. Now, Ava calls me on Friday night. Now, I'm already shooting pool, hanging out with my fellas on Friday night.
Right.
And then she's talking about she wanted me to come and meet another actress on a Saturday morning. Now, I'm already in my night.
Feeling away. Mm-hmm.
No, I'm in my night.
Oh. Yes.
I'm already in my night.
Got
shooting
you.
Pool
yeah.
and doing what I need to do.
Wow.
So I wake up the next morning and I was a little bit tied over.
Yeah, gotcha. Gotta love it. Gotta love it. Well, I know quickly you're in the new Halloween coming out October 19th. Tell us about your role there real quick.
I play Sheriff Barker. I'm the sheriff of the town. Cowboy hat, cowboy boots, but sounding like I'm straight from Decatur.
Yeah!
With a piece of Jamie Lee Curtis, I can't wait.
Oh, Jamie's so amazing.
Well, it was great talking to you today. Oh, man, make sure you watch him on Queen Sugar on Wednesday nights at 10 p.m. on OWN.
Yay! And the conversation always continues at SisterCircleTV.com.
I'm Jay Dorsey, everybody! Yay.